Hello everyone and welcome. In this video we're going to be talking about a new AAA study which was just published looking at six different vehicles that recommend but do not require premium fuel. So none of them require it but all of them recommend it. So why might a car recommend using premium fuel or higher octane fuel? Well, you know, there's three major reasons you can think of: for performance, so more horsepower, for better fuel economy, and to prevent engine knock or to prevent damage to that engine so that it can use advanced timing. So we're going to work through, first of all, how this works, then get into the actual results of the study and kind of compare some of these different vehicles which were used in the test. Now, it's important to understand that the octane rating of a fuel, as it increases, that fuel is more resistant to knock. It's less likely to have knock occur, and that allows it to have more power because you can advance the timing more. So if we look at two engines, how does an engine with premium fuel make more horsepower than an engine using regular octane fuel? If we look at the exact same engine in two different scenarios, this one using premium fuel, this one using regular fuel, this one will be able to ignite that air-fuel mixture as the piston is coming up. So you have intake, compression, power. And on that compression stroke, the spark plug will fire earlier with premium fuel than with regular fuel because it won't have to worry about knock. And by firing earlier, it makes more power. Now, if this doesn't make total sense, I've got a separate video where I dive deep into detail of how that works. But the most important thing to know is if you advance timing, you can make more power. Okay, so now we understand how you can make more power with premium fuel, but how can you get better fuel economy? So if you look at the same two engines and you look at the amount of air and fuel that's going into them, they'll have the exact same amount of air and fuel going in. But because this one has advanced timing, it's actually going to make more power. So we've got air here in blue, green is going to be our fuel, and then red is power. And as you can see, you're going to make more power using premium fuel because of that advanced timing with the exact same amount of air and fuel. So logically, if you were to use less air and fuel here, you could still make the same amount of power as if you had that retarded timing, the later spark plug firing. And so that's how you're able to have better fuel economy. It's by using less air and fuel, but advancing the timing, so you're getting more power from a smaller amount of air and fuel, and thus getting better miles per gallon. Okay, so the first test AAA did here simulating fuel economy, what they did is they took four different grades, so a 0%, 2%, 4%, and 6% grade. They had the car traveling at 65 miles per hour for the 0, 2, and 4% grades, and at 55 miles per hour for the 6% grade, and they measured the fuel economy at each of those grades. Now, the six cars we're comparing are a 2017 Ford F-150, a 2016 Cadillac Escalade, 2015 Mazda Miata, 2016 Audi A3, 2017 Ford Mustang, and a 2016 Jeep Renegade. And there's a bit of variance between all of these as far as half of them are naturally aspirated, half of them are turbocharged, half of them are four cylinders, there's two V8s, a V6, half of them have direct injection, half of them have port injection. So there's a wide variance here, which, you know, AAA put in place to see the different effects on these different styles of engines. Okay, so here we're looking at a summary of that data. So the 0% grade, the 2% grade, the 4%, and the 6% grade. Here we've got our average improvement on the left, each vehicle which was tested. And then you can see the actual fuel economy numbers in miles per gallon here for each vehicle. So interesting to see, you know, when the Ford F-150 isn't very loaded up, not too big of a difference between premium, which is this number right here, and regular octane fuel right here. But as you start to get a steeper hill, the improvement starts to show. So, you know, 10 miles per gallon versus 9.29 there. In the Cadillac Escalade, very interesting to see this huge improvement at a 0% grade. And the reason for this is it was actually shut down into a four-cylinder mode. And in the four-cylinder mode, it was able to advance the timing quite a bit in the Escalade and get much better fuel economy. These were all in the V8 mode. The computers choose, the driver does not choose. So it was just in the four-cylinder mode for the 0% grade, but the computer decided for each of these, it would be at in the V8 mode, running all eight cylinders. So interesting to see, you know, some decent improvements for the F-150 in certain scenarios, for the Escalade in certain scenarios. Not much of a difference for the Miata. The Audi actually doing worse in low grade scenarios, and very small improvements in higher grade scenarios, 0.1%, 0.3%. The Ford Mustang, kind of similar to the F-150, where, you know, at those higher loads, it was actually able to take advantage of the premium fuel. At lower loads, it wasn't quite as needed. And then finally, looking at the Jeep Renegade, a small improvement across the board there. Now, what's fascinating to look at, and which proves the point that premium fuel can give you better fuel economy, is to look at the ignition timing. So here we're looking at the Cadillac Escalade, and remember in that first scenario, so it's at a 0% grade, and this is at 65 miles per hour. So premium versus regular premium here in red, and here we're looking at the ignition timing advance. And so you can see that the timing advance is far more using the premium fuel than using the regular fuel, and as a result, you're able to use less air and fuel. So here we've got the mass airflow sensor, and it's measuring significantly less air. You can see that gap right there coming in the engine, and it's able to do that because it's making the same amount of power with far more ignition timing, so significantly more advanced ignition timing. And then you see in the other scenario, phase three, so the 4% grade where the Cadillac also had a big gap in fuel economy, almost 10%, there also a huge gap in the ignition timing, and a corresponding gap in the amount of air needed. So less air needed with premium fuel, and so as a result, better fuel economy with that scenario. Looking at a different example, the Ford Mustang, you know, using very similar timing for those low loads, and then you can see as you get into the higher load, it actually advances the timing significantly more versus the regular fuel, and as a result, there's a gap in the amount of air required, and it gets better fuel economy. So really cool to see the actual data behind it, proving that, you know, advancing the ignition timing can result in less air used, and as a result, less fuel used. It's also interesting to look at the Jeep Renegade's ignition timing. So this is a super small 1.4 liter engine, so high boost, and as a result, you can see that as that load increases, as you build into the boost, you have to significantly retard that ignition timing so you don't run into engine problems. So you can see a huge dip in the ignition timing, and that's as a result of using a small engine with high boost. So you can see that, you know, significant drop. Now, honestly, between the two, not a big difference. So you're not noticing a huge difference in fuel economy as a result of the advanced ignition timing, and it's only slightly advanced in a couple scenarios. Now, something else interesting to see, it seems like the larger engines benefited more from the premium fuel rather than the smaller engines, which didn't improve as much, seeing peak improvements as high as 7.8, 13.5, and 8.0 in the V6s and V8s versus 2.9 was the highest seen in an individual test with the Jeep Renegade. Now, this certainly doesn't imply that the reason why they did better is because they have larger engines, but it's interesting to see that that's how it played out. So the next test were to look at how much horsepower does this vehicle make. So there were three tests done, two of them holding the engine at a constant RPM, so 2000 and 4000 RPM, and then the brake for the dyno adjusts its braking force to allow that engine to stay at a specific RPM, 2000 or 4000, as you apply throttle. So you apply full throttle, the engine is held at a specific RPM, and then you measure the power at each of those, so at 2000 and at 4000 RPM. Then a more traditional dyno plot where you're simply, you know, just doing the traditional dyno, revving it up from a low RPM to a higher RPM to redline and seeing its torque and horsepower curves. Okay, so looking at the horsepower data, 2000 RPM, so low engine RPM, however, a high engine load, you are flooring it doing this, seeing what the effects are, and then a mid-engine RPM, 4000 RPM with a high engine load. As you can see, a small improvement for most of them, the Jeep Renegade losing a little bit of power, and then at 4000 RPM, the Mazda Miata actually losing a little bit of power. But you know, the Ford F-150 actually doing pretty well, 1.1% improvement there, 3.9% improvement at the 4000 RPM test. You know, 11 horsepower, that's a significant difference there. Same with the Ford Mustang, 4 horsepower gain, 4.3%, 9 horsepower gain, 3.6%. So interesting to see the differences between these different engines here. Now, more exciting is looking at the actual dyno graphs for each of these vehicles. So you can see premium is the dotted line. So we've got torque here in black, and then horsepower here in red. Dotted represents premium fuel, and the solid line is the regular fuel. So you can see in the higher to mid to high RPM range that this Ford F-150 is producing more power and more torque. Moving on to the Cadillac Escalade, very little difference in power and torque between premium and regular fuel. looking at the Mazda Miata, actually a significant difference in the torque curve. So you can see, you know, 2.9% boost across almost the entire curve. There's a benefit there. And so consequently, you also have 2.8% improvement in horsepower. So pretty cool to see, you know, a pretty sizable difference in using premium fuel versus regular with the Mazda Miata. Remember, this is the previous generation. This is the 2015, so the NC, not the ND. Looking here at the Audi A3, and a decent, you know, from this point onward, making more torque, more power, smoothening out that torque and power curve. So looking pretty good for the Audi as well. You know, 2% improvement in torque, 2.1% improvement in horsepower. And looking at the Mustang GT, you know, at the beginning and at the end, not a huge difference, but a significant boost in the mid-range using premium fuel, 1.8%, 1.6% horsepower, adds a little bit of grunt in the mid-range for the Mustang. And finally, moving on to the Jeep Renegade, sadly the loser here of the group with the 1.4 liter, making less horsepower and less torque. Fairly consistently, not a huge number, you know, just 1% torque and horsepower, but sad to see that, you know, an engine that small isn't actually seeing a benefit from using this premium fuel. You would think it would be able to advance a bit more, but perhaps that high boost just kind of prevents that from happening. And you can see here in the data that using regular fuel or premium fuel, you're not going to get a huge difference. So looking at the average power numbers, all of them did on average improve with the exception of the Jeep Renegade, which actually did a bit worse power-wise with premium fuel. And then looking at the peak numbers for individual tests, the highest one for each, some as high as 4.3 for the Ford Mustang, 4.3% you know, power increase simply from using premium fuel in a specific scenario. That's pretty impressive. I mean, just a fuel swap and the car is able to adjust timing enough to actually show an improvement in performance, 4.3% for horsepower. And what about knock? Well, it looks like the only car they had an issue with knock was the Audi A3. And so for that one, you know, obviously you should be using premium fuel because you don't want to run into knock and have engine problems. So ultimately, what's the recommendation here? If your car says it requires premium fuel, then obviously you should use premium fuel. If it says you should use regular fuel, then you should use regular fuel. Now, if it says it recommends premium fuel, you may get a power benefit from it. In towing scenarios, it may be useful. But from a cost perspective, you know, there's not really a justification for it because the percentage improvement you get in fuel economy, 2.some percent, is not equal to the price gap in premium fuel, which is, you know, 20 to 25%, which has increased quite a bit in the past several years. The gap between regular fuel and premium fuel is increasing, even though fuel itself is actually fairly cheap still. So it's interesting that, you know, that price has been kind of inflated there, it seems. But regardless, you know, and of course, if you hear knock, if your car recommends to use premium fuel and you use regular fuel and you hear knock, like AAA did with the Audi A3, then obviously you should be using premium fuel to keep your engine in good condition. So if you have any questions or comments, feel free to leave those below. Thank you all for watching, and I'll include some relevant videos for you to check out and help you understand these topics, if not all of this made total sense.